So this is a webinar on MetaTrader 4, and I'm going to show you exactly what is Trading Platform capable of, what kind of products you can trade on it, how you can do that, how you can do various technical analysis, indicators, how you can place them on charts. We'll also go into a bit about EAs and also some of the more advanced functionalities, such as being able to set up custom and indicators yourself, i.e. develop custom indicators yourself and invest, develop individual systems that can actually trade for you automatically. So we'll go through that, but to start off quite simply, this is an introductory webinar. So just to start off with, if you can see on the screen here in front of you, you should have you should be able to see kind of on the left-hand side here, like I'm circling here, like a slightly yellow pane showing various different numbers, and then kind of in the middle of the chart you kind of have four charts here, so 1, 2, 3, and 4. You kind of have when you launch the platform for the first time, you'll see four charts set up for you automatically. And again, I'll show you how to actually manipulate that yourself, actually how to add more, etc., etc. So if you just take to start off with, obviously you have a trading platform. The various charts are here, and the prices are here. So obviously a client or a user of this platform, would the first thing that would jumps out at you is that obviously the charts. That's the prime reason why traders use MetaTrader 4 is because the charting functionality is pretty good, and the platform itself is pretty robust. It can actually load up charts quite quickly, and etc. There's not a lot of delay. So, just to give you an example, you can open up a chart pretty quickly like that. And as you can see, you can drag around, add or remove various trend lines, etc. But just to give you an example, so if you're working with a chart like so, you can very 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 easily apply various indicators. So. But the way you do that is you select the indicator you like, right click on the button at the top here, labeled indicators, and you can go through various indicators there. I mean, I won't go through each one, but you can play around with various different ones. But just to give you an example, let's say you want to attach a RSI, relative strength index, so just click on the relative strength index, set up the various options in here that you believe that you want to use. And again, how exactly you apply different indicators, that's a whole new different story. So in this webinar will show you how the platform actually works, but how to apply the different indicators, that's slightly more complicated subject, which we can probably cover another seminar if you'd like, but for now we just simply don't have the time. So if you press OK, and everything's more or less self-explanatory. You can kind of drag things around to make them comfortable for you to see, etc. And again, those indicators are, you can add as many as you like. So for example, if you go back under that same button, indicators, go into, let's say, a moving average this time, set up a particular moving average, and there you go. So you should have, and that blue line now represents a moving average now. You can add that as well. You can also add things like levels. So a lot of traders like to add things like support resistance levels. If you can add a level like that, you can add maybe a resistance level like that. And again, all of the things I'm using are just a simple selections on the top here. So if you notice the buttons I'm showing you, let me just annotate that for you. So around here, around the top of the screen, these buttons at the top, they should be able to show. These are essentially all the various tools that I'm using now in terms of for working with the chart. And now again, they are all very self-explanatory. And if you actually hover your mouse on one of these buttons, it will tell you exactly what it represents. So if you start off from the left, you can select how you can view the chart. So select using a bar chart or candlestick chart or a line chart. You can zoom in and out like so. Various indicators we've gone into already. I mean, there are hundreds and hundreds out there, and you can actually get custom ones as well. And I'll show you how to do that in a minute. The various time frames are incredibly important. Instead of actually selecting them from this menu here, You can actually select them from the menu up here. So just a quick shorthand way of doing that. And again, the most important thing here is not that, I mean, how to use this platform is fairly simple, but in terms of getting to grips of why you're using it, and in terms of from a trading perspective, i.e., there's no point just applying indicators, you know, if there's no benefit to it, if it doesn't apply to your trading plan, if it doesn't actually fit into what you're doing. So that's how to use indicators and why you're using them are slightly different things, slightly different topics. So in addition to how to use them, as I'm showing you now, you're also going to need to know why you're using them and for what purpose. It's almost, I would even say how to use this platform takes a couple of minutes to learning how to use it, but mastering it and actually understanding all the various tools and functionality that it has and actually integrating it into your trading plan, that takes several years or several months of experience and of practice. So going back to the platform here, so we also have various, I mean, if you put your mouse on these various things, on the various buttons here, it will give you, again, as I said, an annotation of what it does. So you can do things like text labels, various labels that you can place around the chart to help yourself at a later date come back to it. So for example, if you want to type in something here like that, you can maybe put that on the chart. And again, this is completely up to you. All the annotations you make and all the various how you use these tools is completely under your discretion. So it's the palette is all yours, and it will have to be you that kind of uses that to your advantage. There's not really a right or wrong way to use these charts or to apply these indicators. Now, if we go back out, going back. Just the very one of the very most important things I should have really mentioned before going into kind of the charts is there are essentially four key areas of MetaTrader 4, and I would say they essentially are here. If you go to View and go down this menu here, if you see the Market Watch window, the Navigator window, and the Terminal window, they essentially are the three main tools, and you can access them by using Control M, Control N, and Control T. These are kind of the shortcuts to access these. And the reason why it's so important, so Market Watch is the window on the left-hand side. The Market Watch window shows you all the products that are available to trade at any one time on any platform. So we as a firm, as Alpari, we have various currency in the pairs, as you can see here in yellow. We also have silver and gold as well as individual equities, UK equities, as you can see here. If you scroll further down, you'll see other products such as indices, so world indices such as the US Dow, Nasdaq, etc. The UK FTSE, the German DAX, etc. If you right click on Show All, if you right click on any here and any in this window here, and right click and select Show All, it will show you the full extent of products we have, and that includes things like commodities, so things like Brent crude, gas, corn, silver, and gold. And again, the way you do that, just again, anything in MetaTrader, if you just hover over any particular product or any particular icon, should give you a name for it, and that's been designed that way so you can get an understanding of what it is without having to go into an appendix or anything like that. And so all you need to do essentially to access one of these products is literally drag this product. So let's say we want to look at the US dollar Canadian currency pair, and just simply drag it into a window that you would like to utilize for that. And then that chart populates that window, and then you can see that currency pair. If you want to set up this currency pair as a new window, just drag it to the top of the screen like so. So into the top part of the screen here, and then let go, and then it will open up a new window, a completely new window that you can now play around with like so. Stretch it out in any way you like. If you want, you can actually maximize it by double clicking on the top. And you can also things like you can actually print this screen here, and that will give you a print preview here. If you want to export that in another way, you can actually save this chart as you can save it in various forms. You can save it as a HTML file or a CSV file. The most popular one probably CSV. You can look at it in Excel, or you can just simply save it as an image. And if you do that, again, it will give you an opportunity to save it as a BMP or a GIF file, and you can send that. You'll be able to send that image to via email, etc., or place that on a website or whatever else. So, and then you can see that it is quite, you can utilize the tools, i.e. the end product, so what you actually have, the analysis you have done, you can actually utilize it pretty well in terms of blogs or in terms of sending it to, or using it for yourself and putting up on a, maybe a website for yourself, so you can actually check back on your charts in a much more simple fashion. So one thing I personally like to do is to keep a log of various charts I keep. So if I do annotate a particular chart and add various indicators to it, to actually log that, print it out, or save it as an image and keep that on my for my records. So if I go back to it at a later date, I can see what analysis I've done, and to prevent too much analysis going on one particular chart. I mean, I like to do that, and if any of you ladies and gentlemen are the same, you can actually do the same. It's very, very simple. Just use it's very similar to actually how Office products or Microsoft Windows products work, in terms of the menus at the top and how everything is done. So in terms of placing a trade, so once you've actually seen the various products, once you've actually for example, drag the particular product into a chart, you've done your analysis, and now you want to place a trade. So the best way of doing that is, well, either by double clicking on a particular product on the left, and then you have a trade window comes up like so, or you can right click on any particular chart, go to select trading, and then select buy new order. That also brings up the same window. You can also do that by just simply pressing F9 on your keyboard, as I've just done, and that brings up the same window. And the way you then what then essentially, this will probably be the most important window that most traders use. So if you're quite an active trader on a day-to-day basis, you'll be able to you'll probably be using this window quite often, i.e. all trades are placed are placed you, or sorry, let me just repeat that. All trades that are placed at market use this window. If you're placing orders that are pending orders, no, the window would look slightly differently, and I'll show you that in a second. But in terms of placing the trade instantaneously, this will be the best way of doing so. And the way that, and so just to run through it for you, so you would select your currency pair at the top, but assuming you've already done that, assuming you've already double clicked on the left hand side, or the currency pair will already be populated. If you want to change that for some reason at the last minute, so let's say I've dragged a, let's say I want to trade sterling dollar cable. So if I've dragged sterling dollar into this chart, I've right clicked on trading, I've selected new order, it should have sterling dollar. If it doesn't, then I just have to select it from this list, and this list contains all the products we currently have as a company. So you can actually have another way of looking at it in this way as well. So assuming we're happy with this, with the product, we select selling dollar. The next question for us is to decide which volume we want to use. And so the way this works is, a volume of one represents 100,000 nominal value. So for example, if we select a volume of one, in this case we would be buying or selling £100,000 sterling versus the equivalent in dollars. So if we were to select a volume of one, that would mean 100,000. So one lot is stipulates 100,000. If you were to do 0.1, that would be a value of 10,000 nominal value, and again, a nominal value of 10,000 sterling, buying or selling 10,000 sterling, versus the appropriate amount in dollars. And the other last choice we can do is 0.01. And that's 1,000 nominal sterling. So again, the way this volume bar works is you can actually do any combination. So for example, you could do something like 1.21 or something like 2.98. That's possible. I mean, any multiple of 0.01 you can enter into this box, and as a result of that, that'll buy or sell the appropriate amount of sterling versus dollars. So in our particular example, let's say we want to do, let's be quite brave, let's say that we're going, let's say, for 2.5 lots. Well, let's say, let's just keep it simple, let's just do one lot like that. Stop loss and take profit. Now, you do have a choice of placing a stop loss and take profit immediately. We do, as a company, recommend traders to use stop loss and take profits orders as much as they can, so i.e. pending orders. So if you want to place a stop loss, so the market is currently trading 56.42, as you can see here. So if we're looking, let's say, if we're looking to buy this currency pair, we might want to place a stop loss, let's say, at 156.00. And if we're buying, or if we're looking to buy, then maybe we want to take a tip offer, maybe we want to place it. Take profit, let's say 157.10, for example. We can also add a comment to this trade. So if again, I'm a big advocate of logging all your trades as much as you can and commenting on your on the trades you do, so that then when you go back to them in your trading log, you can actually see what you meant to do in that trade. So for example, if we think that it's, for example, it's bullish GBP, for example, UK minutes, BOE minutes are coming out tomorrow. So for example, if you, I mean, whatever you want to put in here, you can put whatever you like. I mean, I'm not saying Bank of England minutes are going to be bullish tomorrow or anything like that, but I'm saying if anything, any particular aspect you want to log in any particular way, whether it's a comment for yourself, whether it's because it's like a trade idea, whether it's because it's to remind you or anything like that, you can enter it here and it turns out to be quite useful. So if we went to, imagine we've entered this, we're happy, and then we've checked our stop loss, our take profit, we've checked our volume, and then we press the buy button. And we've got the confirmation here. So this is our order number. So if we ever have to contact someone at Alpari to help us with that particular trade or to explain if there's a particular issue with that trade or anything like that, or any query that happens, that's what they'll probably that's the number you need to have for that trade. And then just this, and then the next bit just confirms the size of the volume, size of the order, confirms the currency pair, the price we entered at, our stop loss and our take profit, and the fact that it's successful. We can also print that out for our records as well. So once we press OK, we can actually see that, as you can see, this is the trade we've just done. And as you can see here, it's actually been done at 13:47, not 12:47, which the time that it actually is in UK, and that is because it's MetaTrader 4 it works on Central European time, so all trades are logged at CET time, so that's 1 hour ahead of UK at all times, and that's the trade we've just done. So it's highlighted there. So this is the trade we've just done here. And the bottom of the tree, the most lower of the tree. Now, as you can see, I've done two trades earlier on. So a few minutes before I started this seminar, I did a couple of other trades. One was also in sterling dollar, a long position, and one was in Swiss yen, short position. And again, so as you can see, MetaTrader 4, all it does is regardless of how many trades you have, it simply stacks them on top of each other, and lists them in this box here. And that obviously gives you, and then it's summarized. So each trade is logged individually, but then at the bottom there is a summary of how much I have in my, so for example, the balance of my account, how much equity I've got in my account, the margin I'm using, or free margin, and how much margin I'm using for all the trades I've got, and my margin level. So how much, the margin level is it's equity divided by margin times 100. So how much, equity I've got in proportion to how many trades I've got as a percentage, shown as a percentage. And that is a very good way of looking at your total portfolio to see how much, how many trades you can take on versus the amount of funds you have to take those trades on. So essentially it's a ratio of how much you can trade at any one time. So for example, a margin level close to 100%, so the more it is close to zero, the more you're taking on, the more weight your account is taking on. And we as a company like to prevent traders, we prevent traders from trading further below 100%, and we stop traders out at 20% or less, because otherwise this creates a risk for the trader trading, and it creates a risk for us as a company in terms of having negative accounts, in terms of traders having gaps, etc., and potentially having a negative account balance. Now, that is very, very unlikely, and it almost never happens, but sometimes it does, we can do, theoretically, and we like to avoid that before it actually happens, and so we put in place these kind of risk measures, i.e. looking at the margin level and making sure that it doesn't i.e. the trader doesn't have a huge position that takes him offside and actually sends his account into a negative balance. But as you can see, if you look on this account statement, as you can see in the bottom right corner, my total profit and loss is being shown here. Then if you can see that, let me just highlight that here. So that's the total profit and loss I have on my account. Now obviously if I close one of these trades, so for example, let's imagine I want to close one of these trades. Let's imagine I'm not happy with something. So let's say but at this moment in time, I have two sterling dollar positions. If I want to close one of them out, I can quite easily do that. All I need to do is just right click on, let's say this is the trade I want to close out. So I just simply right click on that trade, go to close order, and then the same box comes up if you remember that we used to open the trade. And so at this particular point, all I need to do now is to make a choice. So what I want to do is essentially is to close it at the current market price, and that will do so if I click this button, this yellow button here. If I actually want to add to the position, I could actually add to the position by pressing buy, and that will open up another one lot in that position, or I could press sell, and that would open up a counter position. So I'll now have four positions. But the easiest one is to press close. And if I do that, the position is closed. And now, as you can see, now I only have two positions remaining. If you go into my account history, I can see what that's done. So you can see my initial balance was £5,000, making about $5,000. And now that I've had this one sterling dollar position, I bought one lot at this opening price, and this is my closing price, and that's my P&L. So I've taken a $10 loss on that, a one tick loss, and then that's my account balance after that trade. So everything is very logical, very self-explanatory. So going back to this is my all my cut. So the account history shows your past trades. Your trade tab shows you your current active trades. If you go along the tabs, if you have there's a news tab which actually has all the current news or the latest news that you can double click on like so, and it should bring up a window for you to explain to you what that news item is. You also have things such as alerts, and you can set up alerts in terms of, so for example, if you're right clicking here and create alert, you can actually set up an audible alert or an email or an executable a file to be executed on your computer, given a particular level in a particular currency pair. And that, again, that is very simple to set up. You just go into this menu and just play around with it. Again, I would always recommend experimentation with MetaTrader 4. The best way to get the best out of this platform is literally to experiment with a demo account, with virtual money, etc. Just to play around with the functions, play around with the order types, play around with all the different functions that the platform has. Because it will surprise you how much it can actually do. There is so much that it's actually can able to do. So that's that. And we also have a mailbox. That's where we generally, as a company, let clients know various events or various news information, etc., etc. Now, a very important couple of tabs. Now, the experts tab, we'll go into that in a second, but another very important tab is the journal tab. Now, the journal tab essentially logs every single action that you do on this trading platform, and we as a company will sometimes may ask you to send your journal logs to us. And the way you do that is you right click on here, you click open, and it should bring up a window like so, all your logs, and each log will have a particular day. If you notice, each log has a number which corresponds to the date. So you can actually send us a log from a particular date to us. For example, today's log would be 22/11/2011, and that brings up a log of everything that you've done on the platform. And if in case of any disputes or anything that goes wrong in a particular trade or a platform, that log is the best source of information that you have and we have in terms of working out what happened with your platform. Just to let you know. Okay. So what else is very important in this platform? Now, one of the things that's incredibly important is indicators. So remember what I told you in terms of very key aspect, and that's in the View tab. Well, the Navigator tab is probably one of the most important sources. So if you click the Navigator tab and just adjust it so you can see exactly what you're doing. As you can see here, I've got two accounts. Here you have all the various top level menus. You have the accounts menu which just shows you all the various accounts you have. So you have I have a test account and my two other accounts I have in my name. And as you can see, that's all logged under here. Now, what's more important than that is the indicator tab. So the indicators here are essentially indicators that you can actually apply to various charts, and actually not just simply indicators that you apply to a chart, as I've shown you earlier, through the indicators here. You can actually use indicators that are custom made, so that are created by other users, by other third parties, various people, other places on the internet. We can get them for free. You get to experiment them for a trial basis. We can actually purchase them, rent them, etc., etc. Now there is a whole community out there on the internet for MetaTrader 4. Literally, hundreds of thousands of users who are sharing views, opinions, various custom indicators, various strategies, etc. And so, MetaTrader 4 is actually a very community-based platform. It's very similar to essentially what Linux is trying to do with, I think, with the what it's doing with software development, and that is, very open source. A lot of MetaTrader 4 users or traders, because they're all trading at FX, there's no real advantage to cooperate here. They do actually cooperate with ideas, with advice about different brokers, trading ideas, strategies, etc. So I would personally strongly recommend people to go out on the internet to find some of these amazing websites, amazing kind of community sites. Starting off with Metacoid's website, as websites like Forex Factory, Trade for Trade to Win, all these kind of etc. And there you should be able to find users who are very active people who develop some of these indicators themselves. So for example, if you were to drag this indicator into this chart, again, the same thing happens. You have a box that comes up. You would set it up in here, like how you would like this indicator to work, and then the indicator would show up on this chart, and then you'd be able to utilize it. But what's even more important is from these not just these indicators, so essentially these are more indicators. You can actually utilize them more, but you can actually edit them, and that's where custom indicators come in. So with custom indicators, you can actually select the custom indicator here, click on it, and actually modify it. So then you have another window, almost, I wouldn't even say window, I would say another software package that is then launched called Meta Editor. And as you can see in Meta Editor, you can actually start to edit some of these indicators. As you can see here, this indicator that I've just started to edit, we can actually edit this and the programmer language is MQL language. And I'm not a computer programmer myself, but generally those who understand how to use this language and will already be at home here, and those who are completely new to this will need to understand how this works, and there are various courses you can do and various books you can read to help you understand how to use this this programming language. But it's essentially, if you are able to master it, you will be able to edit these indicators and attach them to the chart, not only in terms of what the textbook tells you, but in terms of what you actually want to do. And that sometimes is some of the most powerful indicators are created like that, when they're so personalized and so custom made that they're actually done out of by your own hand. And so what else you can do so the next stage after that is what we've done as a company is to develop that further. So to take indicators, so there are ready-made indicators which you can use, there is then custom indicators which you can then edit yourself and create yourself. But the next stage after that is to actually create systems that trade for you, where you don't actually have any input whatsoever. You don't specify to the software whether you're trading, what trades you're making, when what stops you're setting, what levels you are, what pending orders you're putting, etc. And the way you do that is using expert advisors. We call them expert advisors, EAs, and these are essentially automatic trading systems that trade completely on your behalf. And we include a couple for you. So if you were to download the platform, we offer a couple for you. Now, my personal advice is not to use these to trade with. They're very, very simple systems that literally are very linear. They're very, very simplistic and will probably lose you money very likely if you use them to trade, to let them trade for you. Although not necessarily, but they're very simple. I would advise to use them maybe on a demo account just to see how they work, and then maybe if you like them to use them. But generally, I would recommend going on these various community websites, having a look at other systems that are being used and other users that are using these systems, and again, work out what's best for you. Again, the way it works is you just simply, again, take one of these expert advisors, drag them onto a chart like so, and then you will have a window which will allow you to which you will need to essentially allow and activate these expert advisors. So once you press OK, if you see in the top right hand corner here, that our expert advisor MACD sample is actually currently not working because it's got a small X to it. If we press this button here, we have now activated it by pressing this expert advisor button. Now we now have a green button for symbolizing that it's active, and we also now have a smiley face next to MACD sample. So now this expert advisor is now active, and it's actually now potentially will trade for us. I mean, and if there is a trade that comes up which this trading system is looking for, because every trading system, all it does is look for certain markers, look for certain things in the market which it then will act upon, certain triggers. If one of these triggers occurs at this particular moment in time, then the trade will happen, and the system will activate the trade, and we'll see a trade happen in front of us. If not, then it would simply run in the background, and then potentially not trade. But that is the well, kind of the beauty of an automated system, is that you don't have to follow it the whole time. You just simply have to switch it on. Now the downside of that is, you have no control over what happens after that. So the system, if the system has an error in it, or if the market changes very rapidly, or if there is something happening in the market which the system doesn't understand, you potentially could take heavy losses, or that system will literally, because it is, it's just simply a computer robot, it's never going to have human level of understanding of the market. So the best way of doing this in terms of trying to use them is to start off with, in my opinion, through demos, through virtual money and testing. So severe, very rigorous testing of these systems is probably required. I would say is definitely a definite must. And so I couldn't recommend that more. The one thing you do have to remember is, though, with expert advisors, is they don't work if you switch off the trading platform now. So if you disconnect your interconnection, the trading platform, the expert advisor won't work. So for the expert advisor to be active, the MetaTrader 4 has to be open, and you have to be logged into your account. And so essentially, your PC has to be on in order for the system to work and for potential trades to happen. Now, one thing I mentioned earlier before in terms of expert advisors is how you can obtain new expert advisors. Now, the way you do that is you go into tools, and if you go into MetaQuotes language editor, this brings up, if you remember what I've showed you just a moment ago, so the editor for where you will be editing the various the MQL language behind some of these systems. And I'll just show you how that works. So once you've opened that up, if you go into Online Library down here, at the bottom of the screen, go to Online Library, you'll now be able to, and if you go into the search window here, you'll be able to search for a particular system. So let's imagine we're looking for an expert advisor that's specializing in trading the US dollar, for example. So if it's up in USD, EA, this is probably going to bring us some random results, but you can play around with the various searches. And you should be able to come up, you will come up with something. So the way that this MetaTrader works is that you can search for indicators, you can search for experts, you can search for scripts, or even articles, where articles are essentially where people have written various opinions about markets and about these systems. So if you click on experts, now it's brought up several systems, many systems. Just to give you an example, there are hundreds and hundreds of systems available for you here to utilize and use and test as much as you want. And they're all free. So they're all completely free for you to use. So if you were to take, for example, let's say, look, this one, for example, says the expert advisor uses the indicator OSMA. I think that's a moving average oscillator system. There's another one here based on Elliott waves. So whatever you're interested in, whichever system you're interested in, you could potentially take it, test it on demo account, and if it works, then use it on a live account, and that's what some of our users do. So, you know, you're not actually risking any of your money until you're quite sure that the system will actually have some level of profitability for you. Now, that's a quite rational way of doing it. That has a lot of common sense behind it, doing it that way. So taking one of the systems, testing them rigorously on a demo account, then placing them on a live account. And then the way you do that is just right-click on here, press download. It quickly shows you the code behind the system, so actually how the system works, and you can actually see that for yourself. And once it's downloaded, so once the system is downloaded, you can actually go back to your window here. You should have in your expert advisors, as you can see here, we had two initially. Well, now we have a third one called WavePower EA1. And again, we can attach that now to this chart. And once we've allowed it, you can see here that we have now this system running. We have now a system called WavePower EA1 running on this system, on this chart. And again, that will now conduct trades as and when it sees fit. So just to give an example, so everything is completely interlinked. So on MetaTrader 4, everything is completely interlocked and overlaps each other, and everything fits quite nicely with EAs, with charts, with indicators. So you can attach indicators, attach scripts, attach EAs to charts quite easily and remove them quite easily. So again, if you want to remove something, just right-click on it, click on Expert Advisors, and just remove. And there you go. Expert Advisors now not there anymore. The same thing with an indicator. Just click on, for example, go on the moving average, right click on it, delete indicator, and it's gone. So so everything is very explanatory, self-explanatory. There's our two trades still going, and I'm making a slight loss now. We were up on sterling yen, so sterling dollar, now we're slightly down on that trade. So I mean that's more or less an introduction for you, ladies and gentlemen. So if you have any questions, I'm more than happy to answer them. If you put the questions in the questions box, I will try to answer them as best I can. Let me just have a look what we've got here so far. Okay, I have empty four on my computer, but I can only see one screen instead of four. How can I change this, please? Well, in order to open up more windows, simply go to File and New Chart, select the currency pair you want, and it will bring up a new window for you. That's one other way of doing that is to simply click on a currency and just pair on the left hand side, and just drag it to the top of the screen like that, and just drop, and then it will open up another new window. There you go. So. Is it possible to rename the accounts showing in MT4 so I can make it clearer which my demo and live account? Yes, if you just click, if you go into this part and accounts, you can set up new demo accounts. So for example, if you go to new, open an account, you can set up a new account, and the name here will designate the name of your new demo, will represent the new name. So if you put new demo account, this is the name that will go into this screen here. So, or demo accounts, you can essentially set up a new one and change the name of it. Yes, but your live accounts, no. Live account, you have that will be done according to your passport, according to your ID, essentially what you registered yourself as with us. Is the demo account and live account the same? No, demo accounts are virtual money. Our live accounts are real money. Are the EAs at Alpari server on our local PC when running? Yeah, all the EAs are always held on our on your PC and on your end of the on your side. So that's why it's very important to keep your trading platform running. It's very important to be logged in into one of our servers at any one point for your EA to continue writing. Can we change? This is a very popular question. Can we change the times on the bottom? I change it from CET to UK. The simple answer is no, we cannot, because we have the central. The reason we have central European time and why we like to use it is one is well, very simple one is because of charts. We like to have central European time because when it comes to Sunday, we do not want to have a Sunday candle. Essentially, we like to have our market finishing on Friday night and opening on Monday. We don't want to have an hour on Sunday as a candle. So we use CET, and unfortunately you can't change that. And I mean, it is very simple in the day. It will always be an hour ahead. There is never any, even when clocks go back in UK, they always go back in Europe. So there's always a 1 hour difference, regardless of anything else. It's just quite a simple thing to remember, to just remember to add an hour or to take away an hour. Another question we have is, what currency do you hold your accounts in? The answer to that is the five different currencies. So you can you stipulate which account currency you want when you open an account. You can have a dollar, yen, Swiss, pound, or euro account. And I also believe we have now Aussie dollar accounts as well. I think we have those as well. So it's now six accounts you can have your trading account in. How do you conduct a pending order? Okay, that's a very good question. A pending order. If you want to do a pending order. So let's say we have this chart, dollar Swiss rate here. And let's imagine we want to do a buy order in the future, so a pending order in the future. So the only way, the very simple way of doing that is to go to right click on the chart, go to trading, and go to new order. And then on order type, go down to pending order. Rather than instant execution, go down to pending order on order type, and then you'll have a selection of four orders to make. So what you'd want, so the difference between buy limit and sell limit is that buy limit would be done at a later date, but at a price that's lower than the current price, and a sell limit would be a buy so to buy at a later date higher than the current price. So if you want to buy at a lower price in the future than the current range of 0.9121, we put a buy limit, select our level. So let's say we want to buy at 0.9100. We can also set an expiry if we want this order to expire, and if not, just leave that blank. So that would allow that. So this is basically saying I want to buy one lot of dollar Swiss with no stop loss or take profit orders attached to this order at a later date. So buy limit at a later date at 0.91, and as soon as I press place, that order will go into the market, and then you have in the trade window you'll have a buy limit order. So essentially, that's basically saying if the market goes down to 0.91, down to here, around there, I want to buy that currency pair, and the vice versa would have been so for example, let's imagine we did, instead of buy limit, you could have done a buy stop or a sell stop. Now that's something else. Now buy stop would be to buy at a later date if it's the market price goes higher. So essentially, these four order types are very, very intricate. Right? They're very similar, yet they're all very different. But what sets them apart is, so they are either a buy or sell order, and are either limit or a stop order. Now, limit orders are essentially to where you are going against the market price, and stop orders are when you're going with the market price. So if you're doing a buy stop or a sell stop, you're essentially saying, if something is falling, I want to sell and go with it, or something is going up, I want to buy and go with it. And buy and sell limits are, if something is going up, I want to buy, and I'll then think the price will reverse. And that's the same thing with the sell. So for example, if I wanted to do a sell limit, that would mean I'd have to place it above the market price. I'd have to place it at some price above, higher than 0.9124, what the current price is. We've got another few questions. Can I change my bank details after I open my account? Yes, you just have to email client services, and I'll tell you how to do that. So why is a stop loss often restricted to a minimum of 20? Why is trailing stop often limited to a minimum of 40? Well, stops and trailing stops are always limited to a certain amount close to the market price. So the way it generally works is it's usually limited to the spread. So if the spread is current, let's say the spread is currently 2 pips on a particular currency pair, that'll generally mean that you can't place a stop within 2 pips of the spread. So generally that'll mean you'll be able to place a stop 21 or lower, or 26 or higher. And the reason we do that is to, again, for risk purposes, close to the spread, 1 or 2 pips around the spread, we want to, that's essentially to prevent excessive order placement around the spread. What are the advantages of VPS? Well, VPS allows you essentially to place your EA on a dedicated server, whereby you don't need to have your account open or your PC open to have your EA running with us. And again, there are many VPS providers who will provide that for you. Again, if you just go on Google and search for VPS providers and MT4, you'll find dozens who are willing to help you out with that for a very small fee. Another question is MT4 a spread betting platform? Well, now it is, yes. We've only recently launched spread betting on MT4. So now users or traders can actually use MT4 for spread betting as well as CFD and FX trading. The way you do that is you just open up a spread betting account, and you would be logging into a spread betting account, but everything else will be the same. So the market watch window, the charts, all the EAs, everything else will be the same. The only difference is that the type of product you're trading is now spread betting. Okay, how do I see my statement? Preferably the one I can email to myself rather than the account history tab. Okay, the best way of doing this, and a lot of people I ask, if you go into the account history and you go to all history, just right-click on all history or select the custom period and select the custom period. But the key thing here is save as detailed report. If you click on save as detailed report, it will actually save that for you, and I'll just give you an example of how that looks like. I'll drag that into this window. It will go very detailed report of all your trades. That is the best. That is essentially the same currency, the same statement that's emailed to you, and you can actually specify the statement to be emailed to you every day. Just give client services a call; they'll stipulate for that to happen in your account. That will be automatically happen. If you want to generate one yourself, you can do that at any time, as I've just shown you. So just to repeat that exercise, if you just go into right click, select the order history you want, so last 3 months, or last month, or a custom period, or all history. And go click on save as detailed report, and then that will save the report for you, and you can open it up, print it off, send it, email it, whatever you want. When will MT4 be available on iPad or RUK? Apparently, you seem to have one. Will this be made available in UK? Yes, we're working on various apps, including iPad, Android, and iPhone. So that's just coming. That's coming soon. I believe at some point in 2012, I think early part of 2012, that should be available. Can you change the account currency once the account demo account is established? Yes, you can. You just give client services a call and they'll change that for you. Why does the spread vary during the day? Yesterday I opened a gold order with 40 pip spread, but when that got closed at the take profit level, the spread had widened and had closed. Did not trigger. Just to let you know, ladies and gentlemen, all markets, whether it's like equity, commodity, gold, currency pair, has variable spreads on MetaTrader 4. So that means the spreads can be 4 pips, they could be 40 pips, they could be 400 pip spread, if depending on market conditions. I myself have seen a spread in 2008 around Lehman Brothers, and so in the Q3 and Q4 of 2008, spreads on Eurodollar on an overnight were easily 30, 40 pips on Eurodollar overnight. Very easily, and that was not just one-off occasions. They were constantly the whole night at that level, and that is simply because of market forces. So market conditions drive spreads, not really companies these days. It used to be so companies like such as Alpari and their other brokers generally had fixed spreads for many, many years. And as of, I would say, 2009 onwards, 2008 onwards, that was simply not a valid business model anymore. You just simply can't have a fixed spread, or let's say a 2 or 3 pip spread when the bank is quoting you 30 pips. And that is why most brokers now will do flexible spreads now, or variable spreads, because that's just simply how the markets work now, especially over-the-counter markets, where prices are completely coming from different market counterparties, where we are trying to be a market maker for our clients. So that is why it's almost impossible for spreads not to be variable these days. That's why gold can have 40 pip spread, gold can have a tight spread as well. And just to let you know, if you're trading an ECN product with us, so if you're trading the professional, if you have a professional account with us and you're trading ECN's platform, you can actually have negative spreads, because the way the ECN platform works is we take the best prices from our banks, so from all the different banks, all the bids and the best asks, and essentially we sort out the best bids and the best asks and give them to our clients. So sometimes you can actually have an inverse bid and ask price, where the bid is higher than the ask price. So essentially you can immediately buy and sell for a profit. Now that is very, very rare, but nevertheless it happens, and this just demonstrates to you how markets work. You have some market, some platforms actually try and utilize the fact that banks offer best bids and best asks, whereas on MetaTrader 4, because it's just not that type of platform. It's a platform where we market make for you. That's why this wouldn't happen. But on other types of platform, professional platforms, you can actually get that. So very fixed spreads are just simply a thing of the past. How can I add pivot points to custom indicators? Well, pivot points, there is many, many custom indicators which already do pivot points for you. And the way you do that is if you go to Tools, go to MetaQuotes Language Editor, go into Online Library, go into Search Box and select pivot points, type in pivot points. When you click on Search, just click on Indicators, and it will give you several indicators that work with pivot points, and that can be again you have kind of the run-of-the-mill pivot point indicators, or you kind of have a slightly more complicated ones which actually use other things on top of the pivot points. So for example, and again, always remember these are individual users, so these are users who are in the community, in the MetaTrader 4 community, and these are all unofficial indicators which you can double check yourself if you do questionnaire authenticity, etc. But if you go down here, you should be able to find a decent pivot point indicator that does everything you need for you. So let's just check. Let's just see if we can find one. So, for example, this one here. Let's just go back. Because pivot points are a very simple calculation, that's why it's very simple to find one. Pivot points are a very simple calculation of previous high, open, low, and close. That's why it should be fairly simple to find one here. Let's have a look. Hold on. Can't find, seem to find one here, but another good place to find out somewhere I look for custom indicators myself is if you go on just literally go to Google and find various community sites. There are very various ones, various websites that have latest versions of these, etc., etc., where you can have literally ones that have been created very recently, not just ones that are a year old roughly. Let's have a look here. Here's a good issue. Here's one that I know it's not here, going off on a tangent here, but here's one that shows you the dollar index. So it's literally an indicator that shows you the dollar index in MetaTrader 4. So instead of having a price feed that shows it to you from a particular exchange, you can actually derive the dollar index yourself, because the dollar index is a simple calculation of six currency, a basket of six currencies. So you can actually calculate that yourself and have that trading in live yourself. That's just to give you an indicator. The images I was talking about before, Elliott waves, you can have Elliott wave indicators as well. But in terms of pivot points, let me see if I can find that for you. Here we go. Here's one right at the top. Pivot point indicator. Click download. It should now be downloaded. So if we close this down and go into indicators, we should have it in here. There we go, pivot points there. Just drag that onto a chart, press OK, and it should have pivot points there. But it's also got what it has around the chart is also extra. I don't know what these lines represent, but the pivot points are there. I mean, we don't have a lot of time here, and that's why I've had a bit of a problem finding for you, but if you spend a bit more time in it, you will be able to find everything you're looking for, I promise you. Pivot points are just an indicator that's quite simple to calculate. You can actually calculate it yourself. There's actually websites that will help with calculator. If you plug in the high, low, and open and close from a previous day, etc. So I wouldn't worry about. I mean, I'm strongly confident that any kind of indicator you're looking for, you will be able to find it in for this platform. Either through this platform directly through the search function here, or through the various websites. Just another quick question before I finish up here. What are the pros and cons of using a spreadbean account versus a standard account? The pros and cons are essentially not that. There's not really any. I mean, the biggest pro is obviously the tax advantage. So spreadbean, you don't pay capital gains tax, and you don't need to worry about sort of the tax issue is much more lax in the UK for UK residents. But in terms of the technical side, i.e. your trading, your order execution, etc., there's not really much of a difference. You're still using MetaTrader 4. You're still using all the various indicators, all the various tools, as I've shown you in this webinar. So the actual effect on you on a technical perspective is not actually that much. It doesn't vary that much. I mean, the execution, what I've seen, is the same. There's not a difference, really. So it's really a tax advantage. It's really administrative pros and cons. Yeah, there's a tax issue and stuff like that. But in terms of the tools, as a client of Opera UK, in terms of the tools you'll have, so you know, the various search tools, Squawk, etc., all the various account types you have, I mean, that's all the same. You can have a spread betting account with us and have access to all the Trading Central, Opera Squawk, for example. You know, withdraw money just the same way. You know, you can call up our trading desk and place trades the same way. So nothing is really different. Really, I mean, with a lot of other brokers, there are quite a few differences. I'm mainly on execution. Generally, with other brokers, spread betting execution can vary a little bit to the traditional CFD trading execution. And then there's the upper level, the pro accounts execution, where the ECN model, etc., where you have kind of direct liquidity into the interbank market. I mean, that is slightly different. I get, yes, with us, that is also the same. So our pro execution is completely different to our CFD and spread betting execution, simply because of how you access the market. You're accessing the market directly in that case, where we don't even know the trades you're doing. Essentially, you're trading directly with other market counterparties like Deutsche Bank, UBS, etc. So, in terms of going back to the question of pros and cons of spread betting, you know, with us, essentially there aren't any pros and cons. The biggest pros and cons is the tax issue, and there's a very few administrative things like. Essentially all tax related. So on the technical side, there is essentially no difference. The only one other difference is on a spread betting account, you can't trade CFD products. So for example, if you have a spread betting account with us, you can't trade, let's say, the FTSE equity, or let's say the American Dow equity, or the index, sorry, or the gold and silver, etc. You can only trade essentially currency pairs for now. But in the future, and I would say in the next couple of months, the next few months, you'll be able to spread bet with us as well. You can CFDs and all the equities we have, and all the commodities that we have. Okay, so I think I'm going to wrap it up here. I don't really have any more questions from you guys. So Thank you so much. Thank you so much for listening. And if you do want to email any more questions, please do so to client services. They'll be able to help you. And hopefully you'll join me in the next webinar that this coming up this Thursday, where I'll be doing a weekly Makler Roundup, essentially my specialty or my direct role, where we're talking about the markets, what's happening, the latest events, what's moving the markets, what are the market themes. What's the latest essentially, and what I'm looking at, what I think clients should be looking at in terms of market forces, and more from a fundamental perspective, although also cover some technicals as well. So I hope to see you then. Thank you so much, and good luck in your trading. Thank you.